Welcome back. From that spectacular performance by global artists, we will now move on to a production put together by amateur artists in the city at Kamani Auditorium.
The Delhi Ballet Group has been known for bringing on stage many gripping dance and music productions while promoting young talent in the capital. This time around, they put together a performance to pay tribute to Rabindranath Tagore on his 150th birth anniversary. Exploring the various techniques of Rabindranatyam, this group performed Tagore's first poetical work, Bhanushingir Padavali, which narrated the mythological stories of the eternal lovers, Radha and Krishna.
This is basically just a collection of song. It doesn't have a particular story. So Guruji was thinking for a long time, around about 2-3 years back, that he's going to make a ballet out of it. So we actually mixed and matched songs and put some music in it to form a proper story. And it had a storyline and a background.
The bhavas and the abhinayas of the young dancers were much appreciated by Madhavi Mudgal.
I thought the dancers were excellent. Radha and Krishna especially were very expressive. And the way he presented Bhanushingir Padavali with other inputs, that I thought was very interesting. This production, we have to judge not by the excellent. Of course, it was excellent dancing. But the kind of values we project to our next generation. And this is so important in this time and age when everybody's just, so involved with things other than the real art and culture.
For the past 60 years, Guru Valmiki Banerjee, the founder of Delhi Ballet Group, has been working tirelessly researching the possibilities of Rabindranatyam.
Tagore ka jo dance hai, ye Bhagwan se itna nahi hai, jitna manushya ko Bhagwan kehte hai. जो वही महामानव आशे तो विश्व में किसी प्रांत से किसी जात का किसी गरीब हो पैसा अमीर हो कोई फर्क नहीं है किसी जगह से पैदा हो सकता है रविनाथ टेक्निक है रविनाथ का है अपना ये मेरा नहीं है उनसे ही जो रिसर्च करके जो सीखा उसी को बनाया इससे
This dance form, with its own identity, has enough Anga Pratyanga Upanga and Abhinaya and symbolizes the grand symphony of life which embraces the philosophy of God, nature and individuals.
Rabindranath Tagore had actually created this dance to, it was according to his own philosophy, which was all about nature. He didn't accept God as some unknown identity. He accepted God as the Pancha Tattva, the Pancha Bhuta Tattva. So Rabindranatyam imbibes all the values of nature, Agni, Prithvi, Jal, Akash. So you will find all those attributes in Rabindranatyam, and it has all the attributes which are given in Natya Shastra.
The clever use of sound and lighting techniques added value to this production, and the performance of these talented artists were greatly applauded.
The program was superb and unbelievable, and it was such a combination of the pure Tagore's and also some fusion, and that's what I liked about it. And I understand that they used the original musical version of Bhanushingir Padavali and Hemanta's songs and everything. So it arouses a lot of emotions in me.
Though the group has performed only selected pieces from Bhanushingir Padavali, the stories were well woven and beautifully choreographed.
The highlight of the show was that most of those dancers who delivered such a brilliant performance were taking to stage after a gap of 6 odd years. Talking about talent, up next we have for you artists who've made their vocation their life itself.
He held her close and the lover's heart connected. Then with a tug here and a pull there, the two of them slowly rose up and magically started to fly. With slow flowing movements, that was as smooth as the symbolic red fabric that draped them. They cast a spell on the audiences and wooed them into their journey of slow dance and fluid motion. Until they broke the spell with a powerful tug and calculated acrobatic moves that few would have guessed was possible.
It was very colorful, very well coordinated, very well synchronized, and it was a treat to the eyes. And it was lovely to see the costumes and their hairstyles, their postures. We would want more, more and more and more, always. It's always a treat.
This rare performance by the Chinese acrobats from Yunnan was put together by the ICCR in collaboration with the Embassy of the People's Republic of China.
India and China have been really doing this kind of cultural collaboration for several years now, but this year is the year of exchange, as announced by the Prime Minister of China when he came in December. And as a part of this collaboration, we are exchanging many cultural groups between India and China during this year.
Flexibility, coordination, and control these acrobats have over their performances was evident in the act Rolling with Light. Theirs was a universal show, one that combined traditional Chinese elements with modern English music and a little Bollywood touch here and there.
You see, two things are very impressive about this. One is the kind of rigor and discipline and precision, you see. Because even a split second's slackness can spoil the entire show and make the life of the acrobats at risk. So this requires a lot of mental concentration apart from physical exercise and all these things.
It was a thoroughly entertaining show which combined many different elements. The sensuous and playful numbers by the hula hoop dancers were soft, rhythmic, and very intense. The hand-to-hand balancing act was a display of their stamina and absolute blind trust in their partners.
Thank you.
hat jugglers won the hearts of the audiences with their perfect timing, comical act, and their many hat tricks. Each piece performed by these Chinese acrobats explored the capacity of the body and mind and stretched it to its very last nerve. Undiluted entertainment at its very best.
Practice, they say, makes things perfect, and these Chinese acrobats were flawless, graceful, and perfection personified. On that note, we are taking another mini break, but there's more, so stay tuned.